As you can see, the title of my talk is Non-Duality and Relations. This is a topic that has great meaning for me because of the implications. In some ways, I was thinking it might have implications in terms of biological architecture. As you'll see, there's certain similarities or relationships. Non-duality means the universe is comprised of a single substance, fundamental oneness. Now, we're not used to thinking that way, that everything is all constituting or is a result of one substance, but that's in a certain sense a valid way to describe it. Moreover, we are all part of this universe, and non-duality implies that we are inextricably connected to one another. We don't realize that, and unfortunately, a lot of human problems are associated with our perception of ourselves as separate and very often competitive or somehow, as we will see, dissociated from each other. But another way to conceptualize it is to think of ourselves as drops in the same ocean. In other words, again, connected. We are all connected, whether we realize it or not. This is an example of that. Unfortunately, the sound didn't go on. There is sound with these waves, but the implication is that we're drops in that ocean, and the result is that we are all in unity with each other, despite the fact that we don't realize it. In other words, physical objects have relations with each other. That's part of the title of my presentation, Non-Duality and Relations. So, by implication, our relations with each other imply that we are connected. Now, at the other end of the spectrum is a non-Aristotelian logic and the structure of language, so that if we look at something, we say, these are stones. I hope you recognize that Korzybski would have a problem with that, which is what the Aristotelian structure of our language is. It dissociates us from each other and from the physical world as well, conceptualizing it in such a way that we're saying, these are stones. Korzybski suggested an alternative to perceiving the world in a subject-object terms, and to recognize the structure of the world. His concept of structure, I think, is very helpful. What he talked about was, among other things, and this is a quote from him, structure can be thought of as a complex of ordered and interrelated parts. Again, we see the word relationship there, meaning that every structure, every individual item, excuse me, object, has a structure with related parts. The microphone has related parts, and together, the structure of the microphone is the result of these interrelated parts. Here's another example, the structure of a tree. And what I'm doing here is using another of Korzybski's recommendations, that we use hyphens as a way of appreciating the interconnection, the relatedness of different aspects of objects. So a tree can be thought of in terms of its structure as roots, hyphen, meaning connected to the ground, and the ground is connected to the trunk of the tree as well as to branches of the tree and to leaves on the tree. So again, appreciating the use of hyphens here, see it as that interconnection of the different parts of the structure of the tree as result of, or as leading to, the non-dual relationship of the different components of the tree, the roots, the trunk, the branches, etc. We're all connected. Here's another example. Infants and mothers are in a non-dual relationship as well. When the infant is born, it doesn't, as you know, have language yet. And its tendency or ability to relate to his mother is, as Korzybski put it, on the silent level. He's not thinking. He's relating in another way, which some people call preconscious way of relating to, in this case, the mother. And the result of that is similar to the result of our developing a non-dual perspective on both the physical world and our relationship with each other, namely that there is that interconnectedness among us. And I think this photograph is a perfect and beautiful example of that, don't you? Mm-hmm. Can't be better than that, right? Any mothers here? Okay. Jackie? So you know what it's like, right? Okay.
We can talk later.
Okay. So here are some examples of our body structure in a non-dual relationship with the environment. Let's try this. You might close your eyes and inhale through your nostrils and feel the air entering your nose. Take a deep breath. Now the air is in a non-dual relationship with your nose. It's blending, it's integrating, it's entering your nose and going into your body and in a non-dual relationship. Without air, we would die. So it's vital that this non-dual relationship with air exists. Now try this. Also, if you can figure out how to do it, hold an object in one hand. You got something you can hold? And drop it into the other hand. the falling object demonstrates how gravity holds us in a non-dual relationship with the Earth. It's invisible, but it's there. It's happening. We are in this non-dual relationship. And in a similar way, if you were to stand up, you would feel your feet on the floor, or sitting down, you can feel your butt on the chair. These are non-dual relationships also. Everything we do, we hold and we walk and we breathe, and in all these ways, we are one with the world. We are not separate objects. So, to summarize, the structure of the universe is non-dual. Human language creates cognitive dissociation from our environment. That's the Aristotelian language that Krzyzewski recognized so much. It dissociates us. We think in subject-object terms and experience dissociation from the environment, including each other, which is vital here because it's that dissociation from each other that leads to human conflict. In other words, Korzybski referred to that dissociation as insanity. We're insane. We're not relating to each other in a way that appreciates our connections with each other. However, we can shift to a sane way of relating by developing, as Korzybski put it, a non-Aristotelian perspective that includes the assumption of the non-dual structure of the universe. Now, making that shift to a non-Aristotelian approach is very challenging, to say the least. Well, this is the last one. Unfortunately, I don't have the sound for demonstrating it, but here it is. This is how trees and air are related. I sit in the park and look at the trees waving, the leaves waving in the breeze. It's invisible, but it's non-dual. There's connections between the air and the trees, as well as between the clouds. And the clouds are part of our universe, too, and are a magnificent aspect of our connection to the Earth. That's it.